While most investors are looking at AI, robotics, nuclear, quantum, data centers, there's markets that are growing very fast, and one of the fastest growing markets today is the space tech market. The space tech market has been growing very fast, and don't get me wrong, the robotics market is growing tremendously fast. We were just trading them this morning on SYM on a 16% dip buy, which we bought the dip there. We actually ended up locking in some profits here. Dip down big time right at market open, and then we saw a nice recovery there, and we're able to capitalize on a nice little bounce, which was great. We saw this big dip down here this morning. We saw a nice recovery up into about 67 from about $60 a share. And so when we're looking at LUNR, it's a similar approach. We were just looking at the space tech market yesterday. And this company is what we're going to talk about today. They're up 9.5%. And not only are they up to this $11 range, we were just talking about them yesterday because ultimately what we were looking for, this was our video we came out with yesterday. We were talking about LUNR as the main talking point. We were looking at this support here and we were looking for this recovery of about 63% potentially. Now, in that recovery so far, if we take a step back, we kind of look at the drawings and how it looks currently. Let's see if I can get it. There we go. You can see while we're still holding above this support level, it did make a run and we're up 10% today so far, as it's made a chunk of that 60% gain we were looking for up to that $15 range. So currently it's at $11 a share after surging a dollar today so far. Now you can see the overall uptrend, and there's a few reasons why we're watching it this Thursday today, is because right at market open, you're looking at the EMA. Okay, so a lot of times if you're looking at this blue line, it's going to be holding below if it's bearish, it's going to be holding above if it's bullish, right? And so we were holding below here through August, and then it crossed above on the exponential moving average, that blue line. And then shortly after, it continued to hold above, then went back below. And then this time today was a little bit different because today we were watching them not only cross above the EMA, but we're also watching them cross above that 200-day moving average, which that's the opposite of what you call like a death cross when it goes below the 200-day moving average and below, the EMA. And it's indicating more bullish momentum. And so that's kind of what we see here with LUNR. And there's three things to consider when you're looking at a stock. This is what we look at whenever we're breaking down a company. And the first is going to be the market. And the market's broken down into really kind of two categories. You might have, let's imagine company A and company B. One company, might be having a lot of hype. Everybody's talking about it, and they're in a hot market like AI, for example. And then over here, you might have a company that is also very hot, and they're getting a lot of not a lot of attention, but they are doing really good revenues and really good profits in the market of AI. Which one do you think is going to be better? Well, maybe in the short term, you see that one with the hype do better. But the one that's in the right market, meaning that market is growing, there's more money going into it, and not only are they part of that kind of hype, right, but they're also getting the revenue and the profits, that company B is going to do much better in the medium term to long term. And so LUNR has been one of those companies where we've seen more money going into the space tech market. A lot more spending has gone towards this initiative, mostly from the United States, where they've said, we're going back to the moon. We're going to build on the moon. We're going to get back to where we were. It's been years and years since we've even, set foot there. And what's going on with that? We used to do that easily, back in 1970s. What's going on now? Why can't we do it now? 1980s. What's the reason? Well, the reason is that they don't have the infrastructure and they haven't had the initiative. This company, LUNR, is one of the top companies that is working on the exploration of the moon and also optimization of the current stations and systems that are in space. And so that brings us to, first thing we go over is the market. The second thing we go over is the analysis, and that's broken down into A, B, and C. The analysis we could start with, we kind of did a little charting, but we'll get back to that. But really I want to talk about kind of their infrastructure play right now. This is the news they've had. They've secured some recent contracts. They had, you know, a $9.8 million deal back here in the summer that was for orbital transfer machines. But we knew that they were working on getting their company to the moon and helping NASA with that. So then they came out with another article, and just recently, another $8.2 million article about in-space nuclear power technology. That's interesting. Why would you need nuclear power technology in space? It's like you got to be having something big. I mean, we know there's data centers that are starting to get built by NVIDIA and Google up in space, but you know, what's the nuclear, you know, power technology that you need? What is that for, right? So you start thinking about it. But then when we look at, you know, what they're doing, it starts to make sense. What they've actually focused on here is mobility. So they work with NASA. They got lunar terrain vehicles. And then they have prospecting. So these infrastructure services to support the lunar prospecting, focusing on autonomous surface mobility, so probably AI powered mobility, lunar data relay enhanced observation, and currently responsible for operations and data analysis for NASA in the lunar reconnaissance orbiter and shadow cam cameras. Now this is where it gets interesting. So essentially they're launching these they're even working with SpaceX, and some of the news we saw earlier this year, SpaceX was one of their main means of getting into space. And then you look at where they're focusing, they have this surface power. It's the Department of Energy and NASA awarded them a joint venture between Intuitive Machines, so this is the company, LUNR, Intuitive Machines, and X Energy. It's a contract to conduct a one-year study to mature the design of a fission surface power solution that will deliver at least 40 kilowatt power flight system to the moon by 2028. So this is really interesting. They're actually working on building stations on the moon and space stations on the moon. Now, in the current market, there are certain industries that are innovating a lot. And this is a market where, you know, maybe the government, you know, they want to have that dominance of being able to have that infrastructure out there. So they're not only working on the actual development for the moon, but they're also working on the different cargo and the communication and moving of different cargo from one spacecraft to another. Okay, so with all that, what does that mean for them right now? We see them at this rising support level. They're starting to break out today about 10%. Is there something specifically other than that technology and their product and the market that would be driving them? Well, there is their financials, and their financials have held pretty low in market cap at 1.9 billion, a little bit less than that. Obviously today they were more like 1.7, 1.65 market cap in 1.65, 1.7 billion. But they've actually, if you look annually, they've really grown their revenue. The revenue is a reflection, whether you want to believe it or not, it's a measuring stick. It is not always going to be good to watch companies where there's not any revenue and they're looking for the future. Companies that are looking for the future but not having revenue today become very high risk, because every company, you know, again, you may believe this, you may not, but this is what I've seen analyzing thousands of companies, is the early stage companies or fragile market companies will only succeed to the degree that they're able to sell and still bring in revenue in early stages. And so this company has done that. You can see since 2020, they've increased their revenue from $40 million in revenue to $228 million in revenue in this last year, and on track to meet that this year. You know, that's a growth of revenue of about 186%. And in this last quarter, they narrowed that net income, which increased their profit margin percentage by about 85% year over year. And then you got the balance sheet. So not everything's perfect. They have a lot of assets in $750 million, but their liabilities are still relatively high and jumped a little bit more than you'd like to see in the last quarter. But that being said, total assets are up to $750 million while liabilities are at $500 million, and they got $243 million in equity, meaning real money that they have that they could spend and that they are totally in the green, above water, more assets than liabilities. So that's how the financials indicate that they're actually potentially undervalued. And with that, they may be in a position where they could be around $15 a share to $20 a share. Maybe that $25 to $30 or $40 a share if they could get up into that $3 to $4 billion market cap, which we've seen very common in a lot of these space tech companies. So if that was the case, you'd be looking at them jumping not just to where they were back in January around $25 a share, but that, I mean, that's kind of where you'd see them, kind of up in that $25 a share market. Now they're currently at $11 a share with the nearest target up here around this $14 or $15 a share price point. Started to reverse a little bit. It's possible you get a retest back down to the EMA, back down to that $10 support. And that's where I developed a system that takes the analysis that we just went through, all those systems, and runs it through the best AIs in the world. Introducing Prophecy App. This is our app that we use quite often to get projections. Now, I was surprised here because we were looking at OpenAI, we were looking at Claude, we were looking at Gemini, all integrated in this platform. And I was looking at which companies are actually getting the most bullish around this stock. And one of the top models seemed to be Grok, with the one-year projections as high as 55%. Now, that's a long ways out. A one-year projection, 55%. Things could change. In fact, if we just look over the next hour, you can see it is red, actually, anticipating a little bit of a pullback from this $11.26 range and anticipating it to maybe correct back down over the next hour. I see that. 10% gain. But you can see the nearest support level here is at $11.16. So it's looking at this overall trend that started to develop over the last few hours, and it's saying 11.16. So essentially what the AI is anticipating, and this is where things get just amazing. I'm really excited about this prophecy app that we've developed, that you're looking at this kind of trend here. And 11.16 would be right here, this previous support level that it has had. So maybe it kind of drags out a little bit, sells back down in this 11.16 on the near term. You can see that's what that would look like, about a 1% sell down. It's kind of what it's anticipating, right? Now, in the longer term, we look at the projections and you look into the next month. Okay, about 7% is pretty bullish. And you look into the next year, it's actually saying that it's anticipating up to that $17 range, and the nearest support levels is at $10 a share. So also one thing to consider is the top transactors. I was just looking at that. Actually, you got BlackRock recently bought, Vanguard has been buying, and let's see, you got ARK Investment even purchasing some stock in the company. But what I was looking at for that $10 support is that the $10 support is a one-year view, and the $10 support is back down to here into this range. So they're anticipating this swing to play out, this 50% swing that we're kind of talking about over the next few months. And so I think that's really encouraging, and I personally found that the education around this stock, or around space stocks in general, people don't know. They don't understand that this infrastructure is really powerful and could play a huge role in the development of technology and just general services that impact things here down on Earth. And so we're looking forward to it. I really do look forward to seeing the levels, as we could anticipate that slight pullback as we're talking about here and what the AI was anticipating. If you want to get access to the Prophecy app, start experiencing it early, You can get on the first access list in the first link below and tune into our session later today as we're going to be breaking it down. And then if you'd like to tune into our daily live trading, like how we were trading our stocks this morning, we were trading Symbotic. It's a robotic stock. They are doing all the back-end warehousing, autonomous robotics, AI-powered robotics for Walmart and Target. And we don't trade anything short-term that we wouldn't already invest in long-term. But we were trading that this morning. And we also sold Redwire this morning for a profit at market open. They're up 8% today as that trade's been going well too. So if you ever want to see our entries, see our exits, we are there at market open every day, Monday through Friday. So you get some learning materials. You also get access to me if you got any questions. Be more than happy to answer them. Again, it's the second link below for Stockmates if you'd like to join in tomorrow morning. If I earned your thumbs up, hit the like button. Do consider subscribing. And I'll see you in the next one. Take care.